हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 73। बाइडू हैज कमेंस्ड पेड सर्विसेज फॉर द अपोलो रोबो टैक्सीज इन चाइना विदाउट अ सेफ्टी ड्राइवर बिहाइंड द स्टीयरिंग व्हील फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम। द बाइडू माइलस्टोन कंसाइडेड विद अनदर माइलस्टोन बाय अलीबाबा बैक्ड ऑटो एक्स who completed 100 consecutive days of their robot taxi service in Shenzhen, China's densest city. The Baidu rollout operation was significantly different from previous demonstration of its Apollo driverless taxis, which required a safety driver behind the steering instead. A safety member sits at the front passenger seat to respond to emergencies. The rollout operation currently involves 10 Apollo robot taxis operating within a 1 km radius in western Beijing. The taxis pick and drop passengers on 8 designated points from Shaoguang Park. Shaoguang Park is an emerging sightseeing destination and it is expected to have a large influx of tourists and visitors during the 2022 Beijing Olympics. PUBG Mobile India is officially called Battlegrounds Mobile India, Krafton announced on Thursday. To recall, PUBG Mobile India was announced back on November, but the game's release met the several delays due to the government ban on Chinese applications. In an attempt to rid off the PUBG image, the game will now be called as Battlegrounds Mobile India, and Krafton has revealed a few key details about the game. Battlegrounds Mobile India pre-registration in India will go live before launch, Krafton he said. However, there is no word yet on when what will happen as a game launch date is not yet revealed. Apple recently launched its new iPad Pro models in the market in two screen sizes, 11-inch and 12.9-inch, both powered by Apple Silicon M1 chipset. The 12.9-inch model also features a mini LED display. The variant with the bigger screen is set to launch in the second half of this year, but the order placed today on the company's own online store in the United States are estimated to delivery as late as mid-July, about 2 months later. Google is giving some much needed attention to Wear OS. The smartwatch platform is not really in its best shape right now, with some reviewers even telling people to outright avoid them and go instead something like Apple Watch or Samsung Galaxy Watch. The Wear OS also has not seen a major update since Android 9 and Pie. With word that a major spring update is coming soon that hype building around Google I/O 2021, it is always good to see the smartwatch OS get some love. Now it has received its first major app release from the Google in some time. Gboard is now available on Wear OS watches. Writing on a keyboard in a smartwatch is not the most amazing experience ever, with cramped limited space and a small button due to the small screen that fits in your wrist. But Gboard brings their characteristic light typing feature that happens to work amazingly with smartphones over the smartwatch version of the app. Among some of the other features it supports, Gboard supports multiple input methods including gestures, QWERTY and voice, and you can also take advantage of the integrated emoji palette. When messaging, scrollable world recommendation give you more choice so you can find just what you want to say. You will also able to review and update your message on the preview screen, which includes suggestions and corrections. There is also multi-language support. Gboard allows you to quickly switch between keyboard languages. To change the language of the keyboard, simply tap the language shortcut at the bottom of the screen when typing. Gboard for Wear OS is now available on Google Play, so be sure to go and check it out if you want to improve your typing experience on your smartwatch. Google is also teasing that there is more in store for Wear OS in 2021 in the official announcement post for Gboard for Wear OS. We might see more stuff coming to the platform during I/O 2021 or throughout the rest of the year. Google is about to take a pretty significant step that will help keep users' account more secure. It is going to enroll people in two-factor authentication by default. Today, the company wrote in a blog post that it will soon start enrolling customers in two-factor authentication, as Google calls it, if their accounts are appropriately configured. Once enabled, they will receive a prompt on their smartphone to verify that an attempted login with their Google account is legitimate. Using their mobile device to sign in, giving people a safer and more secure authentication experience than password alone. It is said by Google Senior Director of Product Management Mark Risher. Xiaomi ecological company Hype, known for its medical products, has launched a new watch that helps users check their blood pressure. The product is dubbed Hype Smart Blood Pressure Watch and it is capable of 24-hour dynamic blood pressure tracking. It is priced at just 499 yuan, that is $77, and is presently open for backing at the Upin platform. Xiaomi is preparing to launch a premium tablet dubbed as Mi Pad 5 probably in China first and eventually in other markets. Now the tablet's render, battery details and launch timeline details have surfaced online. The Xiaomi Mi Pad 5 specifications are set to include a 2K LCD display, 120Hz refresh rate, and Mi Pad 5 have certified for network access, which reveals it will pack a 4260mAh battery, which could be a dual cell battery. It is said to be available in two variants, Mi Pad 5 and Mi Pad 5 Pro. The former is tripled to come with a Snapdragon 870 processor, while the latter is expected to arrive with a MediaTek Dimensity processor. A new Redmi TV with model number Mi TV M00Q3 has been spotted on Google Play console and a Google supported device. Key specifications include a full HD plus resolution MediaTek T31 processor, it has 2GB of RAM and it comes with an Android 10. And no word yet on whether this Redmi TV will launch in India or not. Xiaomi is reportedly working on two new flagship phones. These phones are codenamed K8 and J18S, and they are expected to arrive as the company's first devices with an in-screen camera. Today, reliable Chinese tipster Digital Chat Station took to Weibo to reveal a few key specifications of J18 phone. The Xiaomi Mi Mix Fold debuted in March as the company's first foldable phone. It is speculated that the J18S is the second foldable smartphone from the brand. The tipster claims that there is a slight change on the J18S and it carries supports a 90Hz refresh rate for the both outscreen and the inner screen. He added that the device has a triple camera system featuring a 108MP primary camera, a liquid lens with a 3x optical zoom and an ultra-wide snapper. Twitter seems to have learned nothing from its infamous hack from last year when accounts of several high-profile personalities were briefly hacked. This time around, the official Realme India support handle on Twitter got briefly taken over by some unscrupulous elements. As always, the hacker used this opportunity to run a cryptocurrency scam by masquerading the Realme Twitter handle as Tesla and replying to one of the Elon Musk tweets. However, the hackers were fairly sloppy as they forgot to change the text in the bio. Furthermore, the space between the letters looked suspicious too. While the hackers may had their 15 minutes of fame, Twitter had restored the account to its rightful owner. The shady tweets have been deleted too. The account had 1.76 lakh followers at last count. In the latest WhatsApp beta version for Android, the messaging app includes new hints that the app will receive text-based trigger suggestions. As of now, the feature is under development and it is not accessible to users. WhatsApp will roll out this feature in the near future for both Android and iOS platform. Stickers are an excellent and easy way to convey a message that are also quite fun. With the new feature, users will be able to quickly use stickers based on their text input. A highly requested feature by OnePlus users will be finally included in the next major Oxygen OS update. Yes, we are talking about a theme store. OnePlus has just announced that it will add this feature in the next major OS update. The company made the announcement on its forum and also revealed a date for the next open ear forum where it will discuss the theme store. This feature will make it easy for users to change wallpapers, icons, etc. with a tap of a button. The OnePlus Android 12 update will most likely bring the new theme store. Lenovo disclosed recently that it will unveil not one, not two, but three tablets this year. The Yoga Duet is expected to debut alongside the Xeoxin Pad Plus and Yoga Pad Pro ahead of the launch. The leading PC maker has released a teaser picture revealing the design of the tablet. Former Huawei sub-brand Honor has launched two new laptops in China. These notebooks called Honor MagicBook X14 and X15, these both offers a respectable set of features for affordable price tags. Huawei introduced the most awaited Android replacement by launching the in-house mobile operating system called Harmony OS. The smartphone manufacturer launched the OS back in September 2020 after losing access to Google service on the official version of Android following the May ban. It is the third biggest mobile operating system after Apple's iOS and Google's Android. At the time of debut, it was expected that the mobile OS could be an important source of revenue for the company, and it seems that predictions are turning out to be true. According to the latest news, it has been reported that Harmony OS might soon power smartphones from brands like Oppo, Vivo and Meizu. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.